Hey everybody, we are starting this match right now between Wayne Pullen and Larry Evans. Both players did pretty well a few weeks ago at Sticks Billiards in Rancho Cucamonga in the Joe Martin sponsored $1,000 event. Wayne Pullen coming in third place and Larry coming in fourth place. Larry finally being eliminated by One Pocket Rich, and also Wayne finally being eliminated by One Pocket Rich. So this should be a pretty good match, and I'm sure these guys have matched up many times before. I just haven't been able to stream One Pocket a lot these days. Pretty good break, except I don't think there's enough cover behind the stack to really threaten Larry on that two ball, but he'll probably just end up making this two ball and bringing the cue ball back up table, maybe go rail first. Not a lot of speed. So that helps Wayne. He's going to be able to get that 12 out of there. Nice shot, frozen into the stack, but the 12 ball hits so thin in such a way as to kind of take the 12 away from Wayne's hole. So that's all Larry has to do is just bring the cue close to the rail. Okay, now that's a little more like it. Wayne has brought the nine ball to his hole now, so Larry's probably going to float the cue ball down table off this 11. So Wayne's got to start all over now. Try to bring something else to his hole. Meanwhile, Larry's taking balls to his side of the table, which can be helpful down the road. Incidentally, guys, if you would like to see a complete schedule of matches that I have or tournaments and streams that I have coming up, go straight to my website, www.povpool.com, you will see all of the advertised streams that are upcoming on the front page of my website. You know, all of those banners that come by, that that scroll by, are all my next matches in chronological order. And if that, I hope that helps the person in the chat room asking me about when my next stream is. And for those of you who don't have time to go to my website, we will be streaming the 9-ball tournament here tomorrow. Starts at 12 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. The tournament begins around 1, but my stream will be up at 12 p.m. So far, it looks like 3 balls are in the kitchen. We've got the Martin rule. Any more balls than 4 balls in the kitchen will automatically be spotted. Shot. Unfortunately, I'm not sure if Moto covered it the way he wanted to. He really wanted to stick the cue ball right against that 3. Wayne's looking at a possible option here to cut the 3. I don't know if that's going to go. Looks real close. The reason he might be looking at it is maybe he actually can't get the 5 out of there. Oh, I see a little feather off of the 1. Helped the 3 a little bit, but it actually knocked it a little further out of his way than he wanted it to. Very meticulous shooting going on here. Moto wanted to get behind the 3. And now Wayne's going to bank this 5 towards his hole. He wants to play it. He wants to play it slowly so that the cue ball doesn't travel too far up table for a shot on the 15 in a Larry's hole. Gotta be careful. Well, he's actually done it. Oh. Okay, he was hoping maybe the 11 and the 8 would cover that 15 ball. Unfortunately, Wayne has scratched. Great shot on the 10, probably float down for a bank, or at least to get the 3 ball out of the, ooh. He jumped up there. Jumped right up on that shot. He's cursing himself. Now Wayne can cut this in, but it's probably gonna knock the 5 out of the way. Oh no, he cut that so thin that he didn't even touch the 5. Yeah. Wayne overcut the five. And he tried to spin it off the rail. Larry's looking for the ball he just made. They got to get used to the fact that the head spot's been moved up table here towards the. Towards the camera. Now, these guys are playing. There's a misunderstanding with the rule. These guys are now playing the closest ball to the rail gets spotted. So. That's how this game is going to be played out. So there's a little bit. The Martin rule's a relatively new rule. It's not set in stone. And so I guess it's whatever they agree to play by. You can either play by the kitchen or by the rail. Any more than four balls in the kitchen means that any ball over four gets spotted. And they're playing it to any ball that's closest to the rail above four balls. And that is just to expedite the tournament so that it doesn't run too long. Larry just keeping the cue ball underneath those balls by Wayne's pocket. I think he's going to take a look at this. No, he's not taking a look at the nine ball. He's trying to tempt Wayne into making a mistake. Well, that was a pretty good shot, although he leaves the seven. So he's tempted Wayne, and Wayne's falling for it. That's right, Demon Euro in the chat room says that Wayne isn't used to the measle ball. Actually, I think he is. I know that he... How did Larry miss that shot? That's twice. Two shots. That's going to cost him. It's going to cost him four balls. Maybe five. Anyway, I don't know. I think Wayne's pretty used to the measle ball. He plays enough tournaments. I know he plays at Santa Monica House of Billiards most of the time, but he plays enough of these tournaments where, you know, he's well seasoned enough to know how these measle balls hit. So I don't think that's going to be too much of a disadvantage for Wayne having to play with the measle ball. That's true. Spanky observed that Larry jumped up. He jumped up on the last straight shot that he had too on the 10. For those of you who don't know, also I'm hearing there's quite a big action match going on. I believe it's on Monday. It's going to be Christian Thiel versus John Schmidt, I think, playing for six games ahead for 6,000 in Victorville. Well, that's going to go in for, Wayne actually does get away with five balls after all is said and done. So I think the total count for Wayne is six, if I'm not mistaken. So Wayne needs two. And Larry needs 8. Yeah, 6 games ahead. I believe the number, the dollar amount is $6,000. And I was half expecting Gary to call me on that to see if they wanted that streamed. I'm sure there's going to be quite a head count. Hit that one a little thick and a little too fast. He's brought the one a little bit further away from his pocket than he'd like, so this is going to be an easy escape for Larry. He wasn't signing up to make the 14 ball, though. Now there's balls in the kitchen. More than 4, and so 2 balls are going to be spotted. Another cut and a jump. Cutting and jumping. So Larry just playing defense here, and he's taking another ball into the kitchen to be spotted. Wayne tries a 2-railer. Almost like he's in a hurry to win. And Moto overcuts. So Wayne's going to hit this away, but he's going to be careful not to leave Larry a bank on the 9. I don't think he'll try it. I mean, well, he looks like he is going to try it. He's probably thinking he'll leave the cue ball behind that 6-11 cluster. Nope, he's going the other way with the 9 ball. So, although he's down 7 balls, he's still playing really conservative. Doesn't want to sell it out too quick. So now this ball has to be spotted because there's 5 balls in the kitchen. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. There's now there's not enough balls. Wait a minute. No. No, it has to be... Okay, these guys... I don't know what these guys are doing. They're now playing three balls in the kitchen all of a sudden. Which... I don't know if I totally like. And Wayne's kind of letting it go, I think, because he knows he's got this game, and neither of these guys really like this rule, I don't think. And Wayne's got, you know, he needs two balls, and he's not really concerned about now that, see, they've got balls in the kitchen now. They're not paying too much attention to this rule. And I think at this point, they actually both know it, but they're just ignoring it. Because it's really a hard rule to police when you're not used to playing it like this all the time. You know, Larry's in a situation where he doesn't want another ball spotted. And Wayne's already halfway through his inning, so you can't spot another ball in the middle of an inning. So now they're going to spot like two, three balls here. I guarantee it. I think it's fifth. I mean, you might want to get a... you might want to get confirmation from Marie, but yeah, I think it's the fifth. Four balls can be in the kitchen. That's what I think. So now they're actually getting confirmation on the rule. There's a little confusion. The rules changed twice in this one game already. And also, I think it's the ball closest to the head string and not to the rail. Yeah. So, but, you know, you need two balls, so you're okay this game. Oh, you need one? Oh, okay. Oh, good. Oh, you're using the tray? Oh, great. So... are you going to get confirmation or? All right. So Larry got his answer, but he hasn't discussed it with anybody. So maybe he'll tell us what it is when it comes up again. So one of those you're making the rules up as you go along situations, but he's not. He's just, you know, he doesn't like the rule. Wayne doesn't like the rule, and it is what it is. No one likes the rule. Mota's making sure the ball's frozen the way it should be. And lined up correctly. And that's what you got to do. See, this, there's no up-table game here. It's, I mean, I don't know. I kind of like to call this a half up-table game. Because basically, every ball you knock out is going to be spotted again. Now it's going to be two balls again. That was a good shot by Larry, though. And we're going to get two balls spotted right now. No shot on the nine because he doesn't want to scratch or watch the cue ball escape.
Oh,
So regardless of the rule, these guys are playing, you know, pretty textbook one pocket. They're playing up table, trying to keep the cue ball close to the rail. That obviously right there was not such a great shot by Wayne, but that shot brings a couple balls to Larry's side. And very difficult for Wayne to come back down table against the rail. So now he's got, now that the game's changed a little bit, and the ball has to be spotted. So this is going to frustrate both players, this rule, which has to, you know, constantly be policed. All right, is Larry going to cut the 10? Nope. He's going to put it in the kitchen, which is going to then get it spotted. No, he's going to do something a little different. Two railer, double kiss. Looks like Wayne gets away with it, except for the ball that has to be spotted. So Larry is not taking a free shot here, which is a good lesson for those of you guys watching this. Although Larry could actually bank that four ball, he's playing so conservatively that he you know, because if he misses that four, Wayne could make, you know, the cue ball could come up and be makeable by, to this, you know, he could have made the six or the nine. Okay, here we go, another spotted ball or two. And Beau Runningen's going to join us.
Well, that's a good thing for the guy who,
All right, guys, back here, and Beau Runningen is going to join the group for a bit. In fact, he's going to even let me take a 5-minute break and maybe get a slice of pizza.
I'm running solo.
Yeah, did you win?
I did. I got the first couple. My second match was Wayne, and my first match was Fred. I'm not really sure.
Okay, so you didn't play Wayne Pullen?
No.
Okay. Different Wayne.
Different Wayne, yeah.
Right. Okay.
Yep, and I played okay.
All right, you guys got audio on me this time? Okay, good. So I'm gonna take a 5-minute break, and maybe I'll find Brian and have him join you.
Yeah, great. That would be perfect.
All right, dude, thank you for coming in.
Absolutely.
And
we gotta give you guys a little time to talk about UPL.
Cool. Yeah.
Hopefully there'll be a break at some point tonight. You know,
Yeah. No, that'd be great. Let's do it. All right. Yeah. This is actually good practice, being on the stream and going through the shots and what you're gonna do and analyze what they'll do. So anything he can do to try to get some of those balls back up table, shoot them in the corners and it's like he's got a bank at the six. Great shot. This one's going to be a little bit of a lengthy game if he stays in here. Wayne will just keep playing tight, but he's going to try to get some of the balls back up table again. I didn't mind the strategy on Wayne's part when he gave up that bank, because if it doesn't go in, he's got a free return bank just to win the game. Wayne's just going to bank that up three rails and leave the cue ball over on Moto's side. Now you could soft roll into the balls or try to thin off and come up table, leave some distance. Any ideas from the chat on what the strategy should be from Moto's side? Got a bank to close it out. Great speed, just a little overdone. Oh, he's just going to pop it back over there and wait for another opportunity. just a little thing like that. Wayne's got the advantage leaving the distance. So we're going to take a little break.
Yeah, break time.
All right. And so I'm talking to Wayne here, guys, a little bit. What have you found? Is there some strategies that you use when balls go up table? Have you ever had it where they're, where like you push one up table so that it spots back up?
Yeah, occasionally, you know, there's something where it's advantageous to do that. I think Larry mixed everything up. It's supposed to be the one closest to the line.
Okay.
He took a part of this from the line.
Oh, really? At the beginning?
Yeah, so I just play that way. I don't know.
Okay. Yeah, Wayne is saying that sometimes you can get a few of the balls, and if you hit them right, you can actually move a few of them into the kitchen in one shot, and then they'll all spot up. So I could see, you know, if Moto can get in a position where he could push a few balls into the kitchen, they're right on the edge there. So. All right, we're back in action. So I think there's two of them in the kitchen now, so they're just going to slowly move in there. How many people out of the 81 on the chat here like these kind of games where they're slow and methodical? Yeah. I think I'm on your guys' side there, because there's the players are going to be doing a little more than just bumping the balls around and waiting for an opportunity. There's, you know, someone's going to come out ahead, or someone's going to come out with the advantage here. But there's it's not quite as clear on how that's going to happen. So, Brian Cady's joining me, guys. Brian's buddy from back home from Minnesota. So we got two Minnesota boys doing the stream chat here.
All right. Hello, everyone.
Welcome, Brian.
How you doing here?
Good, good.
Got a good match going?
Yes. What is this, Daniel, score? Is this first
zero,
game?
0-0?
Zero, zero?
Zero.
All right.
Seven,
Wayne's got a big advantage first game. Sort of an up table kind of thing. Uh-oh. Might have left a little opportunity. Still, this is... I think he put him in a pretty good trap here. Yeah. He'll try to...
Go on top of the nine or go all out?
He might just try to roll it past the nine. Perfect. Great speed.
Nice shot. Mr. Larry is the one that knocked me out of the tournament. 2-0.
You had a little session with him too, didn't you? Another
I did. We had a cheap session. We played like $10 a game.
How did that end up?
He ended up winning three more games than me. we didn't play too long, and
he's the kind of guy you could learn some stuff from, right? I mean, he knows a lot about this game.
Exactly. He always seems to make the right decision. You know, he makes mistakes just like everyone else, but he always seems to make the right decision. And that's, wouldn't you say that's the most important thing in one pocket?
Yeah, I mean, it's really important. Yeah, yeah, your decisions. As far as execution, you can get away with some, you know, you can get away with some stuff. You don't have to go for as much stuff. If you make good decisions, I think you can get yourself a long ways. Wayne's speed, great speed, huh?
Yeah.
That's just a great shot.
He's going to knock.
So I mean, he can just
up,
yeah, just
try to move.
But here's the problem: if he leaves it there, he's gonna kick it in.
Is he trying to bank the 9 into the 11?
Well, yeah. If he doesn't knock the 11 out, yeah, then Wayne will just kick it in the hole. To Beloit,
Wisconsin, huh?
Wisconsin. Have you played that tournament, Brian? The Beloit, Wisconsin tournament?
I haven't played that tournament. It's the rack, right?
No, I know that. Is that the name of the pool? Anybody know what is the name of the pool room back in Beloit, Wisconsin?
I'm not sure, but
Mr. Pool 89.
They have a good tournament. I think they always add $1,000. Andy Kuntz. Is that his name? The owner?
I thought it was Dave.
Carom Room.
Carom Room. There you go.
Right.
Yep.
That's right. Just going to play the cue ball back down table.
Yeah, he's just going to. Oh, wow. So he went for it. This is actually turning around here.
Opportunity.
So he's got the 11, come across table and shoot the 4. Dave Coles is the guy's name, Beloit, Wisconsin.
Oh, okay.
Good player.
Oh, he missed it.
Uh-oh. All right, he's got a chance to close it out here. 11 ball, one rail.
Did they say these two players play about the same speed?
That's a good question. I don't know. Maybe somebody on the chat would know who's a better player. But Wayne's, I know Wayne, you know, he competes with Richard. Not a, maybe a little less than where Richard's at, but he's beat him, you know, at times.
Send the ball down table.
There we go.
Look at that shot.
It's a great shot.
I know when I played Larry, he's a great banker. And banks with great speed. Two rail banks, any bank. He's always close and he always plays with good speed. So, three balls down table here.
So Wayne, you know, he could get a little risky and kick two rails on this 14. It's fairly a safe shot. If you kick two rails, you'll have two balls by your side and the cue ball float up table. That's what he's doing. He hit it a little full.
Now he's coming back.
That's okay though. He's in a pretty good spot here. So I think from Moto's side, you shoot that 9 in, get another ball up table. This is a little risky here, I think. Oh wow.
He hit it good again. Oh.
Oh wow. Oh, that's impressive.
Yeah.
That was a heck of a shot.
Twice in a row. Wow. Still, though, balls are now in play.
Yep, and Wayne's going to put another one down there. I think on this shot, I might shoot the 14 if you can get the cue ball either by the 4 or hit the 4 and move that one to your side, too. Yep. You know, another shot is just even shooting the 4. Yeah, that's no good.
That good.
Hit that great.
No, perfect.
So now he could probably come off the right side of the
11.
of the eight or behind the eight and just play a bank it across. Looks like he's going to try to go. Oh, okay.
Kick it. Soft kick. Trap him behind.
Uh-oh.
Give him the 11.
Give him the 11.
Came up on him. Now.
Now he can play. He can shoot. How the duck is almost trying to get him out of there is almost as tough as shooting the 14. But then.
Can he clip under the 8? Off the 14? Risk a scratch there.
He might be trying to bank the 11 and play the cue ball into the probably 8. The pockets are tight enough where you might be safe on that shot.
This is the tightest pocket in the house, right? After that.
Beautiful
almost
shot.
Almost off the 4 and in. All right.
So, Brian, have you been playing a lot of pool since you got out here?
In the last month or so, I've been picking up my stick a little bit. How about you, Beau?
Well, I only play when I play you, so
okay.
once a week.
Once in a great
couple
while.
Times a week.
Okay. Back up table with that ball.
You know, that was a simple shot, you know, just sort of something where see how he rolled him up on the rail.
He's
going
to try to two rail this, come back down.
It's not a bad shot, but I don't know if the nine's in the way. Because he's fairly safe, he won't leave a return bank because those balls are sort of blocking the pass.
I think how good he banked. Looks like he's going forward. Uh-oh.
That's what I was, okay.
Oh.
Well, that's going to close that game out, folks.
That's what happens when you have a big lead, right? You end up going for, you have to go out, all out for things sometimes. Huh?
Yep.
In.
So we'll get to this next game where we can be a little more aggressive on our commentating too, because we might have more options.
Yeah. So Beau, what are you doing out here in California as far as pool-wise?
Well, playing not so much, but the pool league, we're starting pool leagues out here, and that's going to kick off at the end of August.
Okay.
So most of the it's just another option, you know. There's it's M8 pool leagues from back home, you know, M8, and so that's what our plan is.
Yeah, so Noto's breaking.
Just a great break there.
Yeah.
This could be a quick game where you can just get a six ball run, five, six ball run, catch a lead like Wayne had last game. They actually called me for my match, guys, so I'm gonna leave you solo, Brian.
Solo with
and you can
the Brian.
And I'll be back once I get done. Everybody have some fun.
All right. Good luck, Beau.
Thanks, man.
All right. I'm flying solo. Moto put another ball on his table, trying to move some stuff over on his side. Wayne's turn. I don't know these players that well. I don't know how they play, if they play aggressive or tight. Okay, he just banked it and, got a nice little rub. All right, so he has a 9 ball covered here. A couple balls on the side. All right. Looks like he's going to go on the bottom side of the 6. Nope, he just banged him out of there. Good shot. Looks like he got away with it. He does have the 9 ball. Okay, shoot this 9 ball and come around. No, he shot the combo. A little safer shot, he felt. Can't tell the angle. Oh, he's going for the 10. Banked it off the bottom of those balls. Nice shot. Larry has everything on his side. They are kind of congested, though. Looks like he's just going to brush off the top of the 13. Stick him in the stack. Larry's looking up table. Going to try to bank a ball back down. Nope. Trying to see if anything can go on his side and move the cue ball back up table. Coming back. A little indecision, kind of awkward over that ball. So maybe he'll bank it towards the pack there and get the cue ball back up table. Oh, just legged it softly. Okay. Wayne has he's not gonna do anything risky, just nice and simple. Move behind his pack. Larry has so many balls in front of his on his side that is congested, which can cause problems sometimes. But banks it over. I think Wayne has to be careful. That five ball looks almost dead. Maybe not. Okay. Looks like it's going to be an up table game. Get up by that 10 ball. Okay. Simple shot. Protect his balls. Three balls on his side. Let me switch mics here.
Thank you.
You need a drink?
Oh, water.
All right.
Another scratch. He's on two fouls now.
What's going on, Brian?
Three fouls. The ball count is 0-1.
All right. Is this one game each or?
One game to nothing.
Okay. Wayne's
ahead.
Okay.
Yeah. Wayne was in big trouble and got out of it.
All right. Little ticky move there.
And let's make sure he doesn't get his third foul here.
Oh, he's taking fouls, is he?
Yeah, he is.
Okay.
Now I think the ball count is -1 to -3. So this is going to be a long, drawn-out game here.
Well, I don't know. Look, you see the way these balls are spread out. There's, you know. First one to get a shot might
make some balls. But
yeah, make a few balls.
The thing what happens in one pocket is that you hardly ever fire at your pocket for such a long time. They've been going back and forth for 20 minutes.
On this, just like this?
This game, so.
No kidding.
When you do get a shot in one pocket, it's just so hard sometimes to you know, you're not in stroll.
Yeah.
You know, just fire the ball in, you can't do it. So he's going to keep the ball up, put some pressure.
So you played Larry today, didn't you?
I played Larry. You played good. You know, you gave me a couple opportunities. Race to two.
Yep.
And he did enough to beat me. So the first game he had me trapped most of the game. I went for, you know, high risk, high reward shot.
Uh-huh.
I'm never going to outmaneuver Larry. So
sure.
I'm gonna take a little more risk.
Okay, all right.
So he won that game, and then the next game I had a lead, but he had some dangerous spots on his table, and I you know, a shot that I probably shouldn't have shot, and I lost control of the cue ball. He ended up tying it, and then we had he left me a tight bank, and I tried to pinch it. Ball came over.
You double kiss?
Chitted the corner.
Oh, I
my
see.
My corner.
Yeah.
I stuck the cue ball there, and it came over and hit the top side of the cue ball, and I scratched.
Hmm.
And then Larry made a couple balls with a 6-3, and just slowly he killed me.
Yeah.
You know, once he has the upper edge, it's rarely are you going to get back. He just, you know, he plays so solid. He knows.
It's
knows all those moves.
It's common to die a slow death in one pocket.
Yes. Yes, yes, yes.
All right. So. But
the balls are always, have been up table for probably the last 6 or 7 shots here. So.
Mm.
Wayne had moto trapped a little bit. There he got out of it. It cost him a couple balls. I couldn't see if he got a rail there. No rail.
I don't think so.
So now it's, you know, they're both going backwards.
It's scratchamundo time, left and right. This is an interesting game. It's like -3 each now, right?
Yeah.
-2, -2, -3, something like.
Larry has -4, I believe.
Yeah.
He
so
once in the beginning, and they got 2 more fouls, and another foul. I believe it's -4. Yeah. Thanks, Binky. I'm glad someone's paying attention.
He owes 4. Wow. Oh, incidentally, guys, I got, you know, John Bertone has showed up. He's the vice president of distribution for Kamui Tips and Kamui Products. He's going to be joining me during the next match in commentary.
Great.
And I'm going to try to talk him into giving something away.
That would be nice, huh?
Yeah, that would be great, actually. Yeah. So,
do you play with Kamui Tips before?
I'm having my first one put on right now, actually. Andrew Park, great, really good cue maker. He's putting on my first Kamui Tip. I'm going to go with a black soft. And, you know, because that's basically what Andrew tells me is a good starting point.
Yeah, they're a very good tip. Most of the people I know play with Kamui Tips.
Mm-hmm. He's also, I've seen him, he's shown me a few of his, you know, the Kamui Chalk was re-released.
Oh, yeah.
As the Kamui Alpha version now, because as you may or may not know, the old Kamui product, when frozen, falls apart.
Okay.
And I guess John told me that some guy in Russia in the cold in the cold weather basically his chalk went to below freezing, and after it thawed out it crumbled. So okay. They've re-released it. They've changed the formula a little bit, and both versions, number 98 and number 121, are now Kamui Alpha brand, and he's got a few pieces of it, so maybe I can give a piece away on the stream, see what he says.
Okay, so neither one of these players are giving anything. They keep knocking balls up table, spotting them back up, knocking them back up. So the interesting is basically it's going to be the first one to make the major mistake here.
Yeah, well, both these guys are serious grinders, you know.
We might be here for the next 3 hours. You never know.
Well, I'm going to definitely be here for the next 3 hours.
Spot them back up. None of them do anything too adventurous here.
Yeah.
Which is good, you know. Back on the bottom rail. Another ball spot. That was the first time I've ever played with these rules. Where
the Martin rule?
Yeah.
They call it the Martin rule. It was developed here.
Do you play a lot of one pocket?
You know, I've been playing more lately in the past couple of years.
Yeah.
I think just because I'm getting older, too. And,
sure.
You know, I had an injury over a year ago.
Okay.
And I don't have the stamina that I used to have as a nine ball player. So I prefer a slower game that's not so aggressive. And, you know, one pocket and straight pool seem to be real good for that.
Yep. Okay, so we got a little different action here. And back to the bottom rail. Modal says you can't run out from here. Back to the bottom rail.
You can't get there from here.
Wayne, last shot, Wayne was trying to trap him with a couple balls on the side. We took a picture from where this game started and where the balls are now. It's hard to believe that the balls are laying like this.
Yeah.
Wayne just did an excellent job of grinding it out where he took, you know, Larry had literally all 15 balls in the bottom quadrant of the pool table there, and now he has nothing in his area. Knocks another ball. Maybe he's practicing a bank shot there. Neither one of them shot at their pocket.
Yeah, Wayne owes four, Moto owes two.
Moto owes four?
No, Wayne owes four. See the coin? And
that's Moto's side.
Oh, is that Moto's side? Then Moto owes four, and Wayne owes two.
Yeah. But neither one are going to let the cue ball get up table.
You know, I don't even... Yeah, I was just about to say that in commentary, that the Martin rule, in a way, is kind of making this game worse and longer.
Yes, because they're just trading the, you know, knocking the ball up table, coming back, knocking the ball up table, coming back. So,
I mean, the only way this game is going to slow down is if they freeze the ball to the rail every time they come to the table.
Yeah.
The cue ball, that is.
If all the balls are up the table, normally you get like a wedge or something like that, but there's shots that people play off of that. And what's going on now is just the ball's going up table, two ball back, and nothing's happening. Right.
Balls are being spotted almost every shot.
Yeah, and neither one of them are going to...
See, when you can bring the cue ball to the rail like that, that's when this rule doesn't really help.
Yep. I think...
Or does help, actually, because, he's just going to freeze.
Yep, and come back.
And there it is. Bring it back to the...
At the table, there
look
go.
At this.
Yep. That was a good shot.
The nine ball is now...
Now he can't.
Now the cue ball's in a sandwich.
Yep. Nice shot. That's just a little trickery. And there we go. Underneath that ball.
Yeah.
Okay. But now... Oh. Okay. He's going to just... Knock it back up.
And there's a ball going to be spotted.
See, if one can get a ball on their side and trap it behind one of those walls, with the ball's, you know, going up table and stuff, then they'll definitely have a big advantage. And they both have a little bit of congestion on their side. That 9 and 13 ball is a big disadvantage for Moto, just because nothing banks to his hole.
Yeah, you know,
you can't get a good rub on it or anything.
You know, upon further reflection, I think what I want to do is talk to Marie about changing the whole format of this tournament, just based on time constraints.
Sure.
Maybe instead of making this a race to two, make this like a race to 21 balls or 18 balls. Do you understand what I'm saying?
Well, yeah, that's a little different, you know. Balls are going to get spotted up a lot during that time. But one thing is, if you end up at the end, balls keep getting spotted up, you know, you're basically going to have the same shot. If you can get the same position, same shot.
Yeah.
You know.
Well, eventually someone's going to take a chance, but, you know, it's just a matter of when. Look at all these balls are being spotted up.
Yeah, I think... You know, now, you know, good Moto banks. I think
he can bank this 14.
Nah, it's not. I guess it's not down far enough. Not enough ball spotted.
There's no incentive either, really.
No. But I don't know how this, that 13's laying off the 8, if he could bank that into the 8 and put it on his side. Or on the 4 ball. The 2 balls on the head spot there.
Mm-hmm.
But these guys, yeah, they lock it down. They're not gonna play, you know, an hour game and blow it on one shot. You know, they're just not gonna do that.
Well, I'll tell you what. While this is going on, why don't we get to know you a little bit, Brian? You're from Minnesota, is that correct?
I am from Minnesota. I moved out here maybe 3-4 months ago.
Okay.
And
you were friends. You're still friends.
Yep.
With Beau Runningen, who is also from Minnesota. So you guys, did you meet there or?
Yes, we met there through pool. Beau's a great guy. He's a great, you know, he's just a great ambassador to pool. You know?
Uh-huh.
He shoots great. He doesn't, you know, he's very modest. And if you ever have a question, he's there. He'll answer it. You know. If you're looking to learn how to play pool, you know, Beau is just a great teacher,
mm-hmm.
you know.
Mm-hmm.
And so that's kind of how I got to know him. I took a couple lessons from him, just hung out with him a little bit. But, yeah, it's kind of a coincidence that Beau had moved here about a year ago.
Oh, I see. You guys didn't really plan this whole thing.
No. And we noticed that, you know, coming out here, it was just odd that there wasn't a pool league every night of the week at the different pool halls that we visited.
Yeah.
You know, back at home, we have pool leagues every single night.
Oh, really?
And it's packed.
Different organizations, too, like TAP and APA and BCA.
Some BCA, some Valley.
How about the ACS? Are they out there?
Not really. The biggest league at back home is called M8, and it has, that was a nice shot. He might have given, it was kind of a good shot, but kind of a bad shot. If he has the right angle to bank this ball up, Wayne has opportunities to get some, to score some points here.
Let's see what happens.
I don't know, if it's kind of laying a little low, I think.
No, it's not. That's right, perfect. Oh, and look what he gives up.
Yeah. There's a little rolls in one pocket too, like any other pool game. So what? He's gonna go all the way down and then go for the 7 next. It looks like.
Yep, that's exactly what he's gonna do. And he's bumped off the rail a little.
Yeah. And he's good at these.
He'll just bring the 7 to his side and trap the cue ball and for cover behind
he's
the stack.
At reversing this shot. Oh, right up against the ball.
Oh, he's good. He's created the cover there with the 14.
Yep.
So this changes the dynamics of the game a little bit. Hopefully we'll get moving.
Yep, the game.
Larry owes 4 balls, but now he's got 1 to give, so it'll bring it down to 3 balls.
Yep. Like I said,
the M8 league, you're saying?
M8 league. Back home, it's huge. They have it in, you know, over 5,000 members. Strong. It's been going on for almost 20 years now.
Just in that state?
Just
or
in that metro, mainly the metro area.
Of Fargo?
St. Paul and
Minnesota.
Yeah, Minnesota. St. Paul and
well, that was a good shot.
Okay. Now,
Wayne doesn't do much with that shot. He really just contains the situation.
Yes, buys time, but, you know.
Larry's just going to, you know, probably try to follow this. He's looking at banking the 3 towards his hole, but I like just banking it up table a little.
Well, he's gonna bank it.
Yeah, that's what I like.
Yeah, okay.
Leaving the cue behind the stack again, because the 7 is the key ball that he wants to protect. So
and it looks like the 10 ball does pass.
Yeah.
He's going to squat this ball and bank him. Oh, he just went for the
Yeah, but that's not good.
Oh, look at this.
Oh, my goodness.
So each had a kind of a good roll here. He's going to soft kick. behind.
Yep.
Did it come up a little bit?
Creates cover. Yep, he created cover.
Okay.
And notice these guys are very carefully trying to cover the ball that and protect the ball that is close to their pockets.
Yeah,
that's one of the key things in one pocket, because you're able to keep the pressure on your opponent to do something right away instead of just, you know, typically try to just bring balls to your side of the table.
Yep. Very, you know.
And once again, using the cue ball.
Nice shot.
He really tried to bring the cue ball behind the 11 and the 12,
yep,
making it even more difficult for Wayne to escape.
But he gives him a little air here, but that was a great shot, because he didn't leave him. You know, he went high enough where he didn't leave a bunch of banks. What's he doing? Oh, he kicked him behind it, and he hit the ball in the jaw.
That was risky. Yeah. So now Moto's starting over.
Yep. Got to move balls again. Maybe he's going to get back by those two balls by side pocket again. Nudge a ball. Oh, he's going to play it. See it? He just never gives up anything. He just nothing. He says, okay, I'm not going to get an unlucky roll, or I'm not going to get an unlucky kiss. He's just going to, he knows what's going to happen on that shot, and he knows he's going to leave nothing. So. Jacked up. I don't know if he has room up for that 13. If it passes a 6, he could bank it down by his pocket, get some cover. You know, not to make it, but get it by his pocket. But this shot's good. He doesn't leave anything this way either. And the ball gets spotted again. It's like two balls.
They're forgetting. Yeah. They'll remember, though, real quick.
Maybe they'll just come on agreement. No, two ball spot. Back to square one. Moto had something cooking there, but Wayne escapes again.
So you've got the M8 League in St. Paul.
Yep.
And 5,000 strong. And so, is this your pool resume out there? You've just mainly played league out there?
I've played league out there. I've actually started a league from M8 before, from scratch.
Oh, and so you were like a league operator as well?
If you want to say a league operator, yes.
Okay. Out in Minnesota?
Yes, and that was years ago.
Okay.
I've been playing pool almost off and on for 20 years, so.
Okay. So now, the real news is that you and Beau are sort of doing the M8 thing out here, aren't you?
Yes, we've started, already gone to several locations, talked to the pool room owners, different venues to get the permission to talk to people about our leagues there, and they will host our league. So. It's pretty exciting. Right now, in the next month, we are looking at just recruiting players, getting people interested in playing. And
so just creating like an email list of some kind.
Yeah, and figuring out where people want to play out of.
Sure.
Scheduling, how many teams exactly we're going to have.
Mm-hmm.
And more ball spot here. But our league, The reason why it's so popular back in Minnesota for almost the last 20 years is that the handicap system used is just gives everyone that plays a fair chance to win.
Yeah.
You know.
So it's a handicap system, and Beau tells me that the ratio is really good. Like I think you guys had, or UPL, is it Ultimate Pool League, or M8, had done a statistic,
yes,
where they had realized that in a million matches played within this 5,000 person, yes, league, in 1 year
over the course of the history of the league.
Okay, so somebody did a total, yes, tally of all the matches for the M8 league. And 72% was it?
Yes.
Were hill-hill matches.
Hill-hill matches. Where?
Out of a million.
Out of a million matches. So that's,
That's the handicapping system.
Yes, that's why it, you know, everyone.
That's how close and it's an algorithm of some kind, or.
Yes, I mean, it goes by.
It's a score sheet that they have. They tally up their shots or their innings or their.
It goes by several different factors. It goes by balls made per turn.
Okay.
We're talking eight ball now.
Right.
And it goes by safeties that you shoot. It goes by, yes, it also takes consideration your innings.
Okay.
Takes consideration who you're playing.
Okay.
The player that you play is ranked higher and, right. and you beat them.
Yeah. And the game is eight ball, right?
Eight ball. Ball in hand rules eight ball. And it's based on a point system.
Right.
So you're going to be ranked anywhere from 40 to 125. And you have to get to your handicap before your opponent does. And that's 1 point for each of the object balls and 7 points for the eight ball.
Okay.
Total of 14 points in the game.
All right. So based on just this point system, you guys have been able to calculate a handicapping that is extremely accurate. 72% out of a million matches going hill-hill is, you know, pretty amazing. Pretty amazing to me.
It is. I mean, the average of, like, APA league, and that is, like, 18%.
Okay, so there you have it.
And I'm not saying.
But they're mostly, are they playing 8-ball or 9-ball mostly?
They play both.
They play both.
And they have a good handicap system, too. Mm-hmm. And, you know, we're, basically our goal here is to promote pool in general.
Right,
you
right.
know, whether it's our league, someone else's league, it doesn't matter, you know. We just want more mass people playing leagues.
Sure. And actually, I just want to tell the audience, too, that normally when you think of a league, you think of bar table only, right?
Correct.
Now, but what you guys have told me is that actually, initially, you're really looking at the bigger rooms with the bigger tables, aren't you?
Bigger tables, because right now we'll eventually have, you know, local bars involved.
Sure.
For different venues, but
bigger tables where players convene and.
Yes, as of now, it's been working out where a lot of the pool rooms have big tables.
Yeah.
You know? So this can be played on a big table. It can be played on a small table. It doesn't matter.
Yeah. And once again, we're talking about eight ball. You know, which is, I like the idea of bringing 8-ball back, especially to a 9-foot table.
Yeah, 8-ball is a great game. There's lots of strategy. There's, you know, you got to be able to run out power, pattern.
Yeah.
A lot to it, you know. And the great thing about it is that our league, you know, even if people have never played leagues before, okay, they can play this league.
Yeah.
People don't play leagues just because it can be intimidating. You know,
yeah.
A guy that just bangs balls around, asks, you want to play leagues? And they go, no, you know, just, you know, they think they'll never get a shot. They think they never have a chance. But this league is just, look at that, behind those balls again. No, this is the second time that Wayne is trapped up table.
Well.
Threat going.
There's no shot for Moto here.
No.
And in the last 15 minutes, we've only seen a change of one ball, where Moto owes three and Wayne owes two.
But they're both making great shots. Just because, you know, you don't make a ball.
Yeah, they're both playing extremely great. Conservative, and they're getting really good rolls. You know.
What are you doing here? We're all going back down table.
Look at this. I mean,
you know.
That's a good shot, considering where he was.
Very good shot. You know, like,
Wayne doesn't have much of a shot here.
Yeah. I'm a one-pocket player. I like to put a lot of pressure on the other player. Like, I like to send balls to my pocket. And if I leave him a ball, you know. Good shot.
Yeah. Now, that was a little more productive, you know.
Yes.
I mean, a little more speed, he could have really...
Yep,
turn the screws on Moto here, but it was productive because it brought the 13 over, you know.
Yep. He just wants to play cue ball on that shot.
So
you know. Yeah.
Well, you know,
I might have left them that bank.
Yeah, so I've been running into you actually, like left and right lately. Yeah. You've been going to all the rooms and handing out leaflets and flyers on the basic format and whether or not people are interested. So, I'm assuming you guys are. That's a good shot, and that's going to be worth four balls minimum.
Yep.
Assuming that, well, no, I mean, Wayno's too.
Yeah.
That might not be the game.
Oh, that's right. I keep forgetting about that.
Yeah, there's a lot of balls, though.
We're going to have another spot fest again. You're hardly ever shooting at your pocket, and it just happens that way.
Well, you know what? You play safety this much, you're getting cold at shooting.
Yep.
You know, you lose your firepower when you're you know, laying up every other shot, or every shot, actually.
Yeah. Is that ball spot good on there? Does it go now? Two spots. It might go.
So, as a league, though, it's what? How much a week, or how much a night?
The leagues run, as far as league fees go, mm-hmm. it's $8 a week.
Just $8 to show up and play on your team.
Yeah. And it's five-man team.
Okay.
It does go.
With a couple of subs.
And you can have up to 3 subs.
Okay. There we go.
You kind of forced it in.
He was trying to make something happen and stun the cue ball behind the 7, maybe make the 7 afterwards, but he didn't come up enough, but he just knocks the...
Trading balls here.
Yeah, well, each player gets a ball.
We're almost to 0-0.
And now we got balls in the we're almost to 0-0. We got balls in the kitchen again.
Yeah.
Meanwhile, based on this, I'm losing viewers.
The league is going to be available at different venues. And it's mostly on big tables, just because that's where the places have these big tables.
Yeah.
And it's $8 a week, up to 5-man teams, up to 3 subs on your team. And it's 14-week season, 2 weeks of playoffs.
Well, that's all right.
Yeah, 3 sessions a year.
Yeah.
And then at the end of the year, we have a big tournament. This is based on if we have 64 teams. Cue ball control, huh? Might have left him on bank.
Yeah, Rich will bank this. He'll bring the cue ball forward and hopefully have a shot on the 1 right afterwards.
But,
I think he's too straight. I don't think he can get any angle on the cue ball.
Yeah. So if based on 64 teams, we'll have... end of the year tournament where we're going to give away 10,000 for the first place team. That's not 10,000 added to the tournament.
That's not just 10,000 prize fund either, right?
No, it's
guaranteed to the
first place team. That's based on 64 teams.
Well, great.
So, yep, you just try to steal a ball. Don't go for them.
So, Facebook, website, is there?
Facebook, it's UPL.
Was it just Ultimate Pool League?
Ultimate Pool Leagues CA is the Facebook. We just opened the Facebook up recently here. And there's contact info on there.
There you go. And relatively small audience so far, but...
Yeah, we just opened it up, so we're passing out the business cards that have the website on the business cards.
Oh, so there is a website now.
Not... on just Facebook.
The Facebook page.
Wayne got away with that shot. He hit that one badly. It might be a combination here. I'm not sure how much of that two sticking out.
Well, the two sticking out exactly the way it was when Larry made it before.
Okay.
But the one's in the way.
Oh, yeah.
This would be a crazy shot here. He's going to play this slow and try to bring the cue ball back up towards the side pocket again.
Now he has a threat behind those two balls.
Yeah, he's covered.
Yep.
He wanted to cover the one ball, but he hasn't. He hasn't covered the one.
He hasn't. Okay. Yeah. If he were to cover that one ball, then in big trouble. Now he might bank, either go under the two or into the two full with the one. No, he just traps him on his side. Didn't quite get there.
No, he traps him. He can't get the 13. So. There's a bank on the one, though.
Yeah. Now he's going to... might cover both these balls.
So for those of you who are curious about the Ultimate Pool League here, I've posted the Facebook group page in the chat room. Just go ahead and click on that and give it a little read. There should be an About page there, right? An About.
My friend Beau made the page.
Okay, great.
So... I am, unfortunately, computer handicapped.
Okay. Hold on a second.
Well, for this style of players, it's, for me, it works great because I just fire in the pocket. Yeah.
All right, so.
In this situation again, they're knock balls up to. Oh! Oh, that was exciting. You ever get those play pool and you're like, oh!
Yeah.
Get that up and down feeling.
Oh, yeah. The anxiety.
Yeah. That's what happens when you play a long game like this, and then you finally do get that opportunity. It just makes that shot so much tougher.
Yeah.
You know.
Just give me a second, Brian. I'm going to check on my sponsor, Kamui, here.
Yep.
Make sure they're okay. Make sure they got enough beverages and stuff. I'll be right back.
Solo, yeah, it doesn't matter. Flying solo again. Okay. Larry standing right in my way. Balls are going back up table again. They each had a couple opportunities here. On his side of the table, covered, two covers, the 10. Oh, I keep forgetting about the ball that spots up. So we probably just knock this one ball up table and keep the cue ball down at the bottom again. And all those balls on Moto side, just there's nothing that banks there, so. Ooh, okay, almost hit that ball. They might, I don't know if he's going to two-rail it or just cross it. No, two-rail it. To the side. This time. Can't quite see the angle here. Just going to just... knock it to the bottom rail, come bottom rail, cue ball again. Cue ball's been on the bottom rail or the top rail? Awful lot this game. And this time he might just cross it. Put it on his side. send the cue ball down. This has got just a couple balls open here. Ball spots with this rule, this kind of, you know, one pocket you do get the same position over and over again, but basically they're just hitting the shot back and forth, the same shot. Oh, that's a little different. I don't know if you meant to do that. Obviously you meant to do change the position maybe, where he's not shooting the same shot. These guys have a lot more knowledge than I do. I'd maybe, I play a lot of aggressive. Like here, I'd maybe kick the eight, go underneath the eight, and kick it towards my pocket, stick the cue ball there. Really isn't any threat on Wayne's side. Just to be kind of careful. Wayne's always faced with the same shot of just keeping the cue ball down table, and he's not doing anything to, you know, help, you know, put balls on his side or trap Larry. So always shooting those shots, you're never really, you know, you can never win because you're never doing anything. So here again, I would just put him on top of those balls down there. Protect the 10. Yeah, that's what he's doing. Put on top of the ball. Larry has three balls on his side towards his pocket. Wayne is just trying to buy another shot here. He's looking to see if anything goes that way. He's gonna thin off the eight, spin it down, getting by that side, and he scratched. Well, Wayne knows two. Larry's even. Larry has opportunity here, but like I said, it's when you haven't shot a shot for so long, these shots aren't piece of cake. Spun it. Soft spun it in. It looks like after these balls, the 13 can go in. He gets the right and he didn't make it. Look at that. Spun it in, didn't make it. So Wayne's gonna try to probably hit off the rail with this object ball, with this 12 ball, sink Larry's ball, and the 12 ball will go to the other side of the table, hopefully up the table. Yep, nice and hard, there you go. Scores 2-2. Trying to decide if a ball, well, this is big, if a ball, no, two ball spot, one ball spot, he'd have a bank. But he's gonna spin this, try to get it on the other side of six. Nope, he's gonna just try to make it. Trying to steal the ball. He's like, hey, how'd I miss that? This is the tightest table in the house also. So shots just don't go in very easily. Wayne's looking up table. See if he's gonna move something. Well, he might be a little aggressive. He's gonna try to bank this ball. Oh, look at that shot. Try to two rail, trap Larry on his own balls. There is a combo, but Larry is not falling for it. He has a lead by four balls. He's going to send the ball back up table. Oh, almost scratched. That ball has to slow down. It's interesting, Wayne. No, he's not comfortable with that bank. Just banks that other ball out. I think Larry, if he can get... Yeah. He's going to get those balls out of there. Wayne's going to get the seven ball out of there. And then Larry's going to shoot from the bottom rail again. Time to shoot here. You can't see what the shot he has. Okay. Gonna try this bank shot. Looks like it. No. How'd he hit it? No. Caught it full. Wayne has a shot here. I don't know if he's going to pull it back. He might try to go between. No, he's going to leg it and stick him. Now Wayne has a threat going. He might have left him the 14 ball though. He did. Kind of shot he has afterwards. He's gonna
14
goes. I don't know if he's gonna put it in his pocket and stick him, or he's gonna make it and then try to take out the eight. No, he made it. But he kind of trapped himself though. Looks like he's gonna go for this combo. No, he's not. He's looking. I think that was the only problem with that shot, is that he gets a ball, but he doesn't get position anywhere. So he's going to try to lock him up on another ball here. Yep. He might have left him. Might have left him the combo, but it's not something he can stroke in. He'll leave him a shot if he doesn't make the combo. So Wayne's a very patient player. He's just going to nudge the ball, retrap him. Move the ball, put another ball down table. That was a great shot. That was a great shot. Some players would have shot that combo. He just found a better shot. Now he got four balls in play for him. Larry stuck in between two balls. He might take a scratch. Not sure. Can't see how stuck he is on those balls. Looks like he's trying to see if he leaves the cue ball where he's standing right now, if he's going to be safe. Okay, this game's starting to progress here. Wayne has got him trapped. Good. Yeah. They're just trying to figure out something to do here. You might just roll up on another ball. I don't know. It's in a tough spot here. It's an important shot here. Okay. He's trying to double him up on the 1-8. He made the ball in the corner so that the two balls would tie up on the spot there. So that was a very creative shot. Unfortunately, he didn't quite get there. But Wayne has to come out off the rail. Nope, one rail. Out. Looks like he might come straight across and bump the three. He might go for the seven first. Depends on what type of angle he's comfortable with. Oh, bump it. Oh, good shot. Got a little thin on the seven. He's gonna just go very softly. Nice shot. Spun it in. Lots of spin on that shot. Well, score a few balls here. 1, 2, 3. Open up table. A lot of those balls are going to get spotted up, so just has to remember that. Going back and forth here a little bit. Oh. Hit something with his shirt and put it back. Looks like he's gonna two rail this. Down to his hole. There's a ball high, ball low, and ball's coming up on the spot. Couple balls. Okay, score is 3-2. Larry's ahead by one ball. We're out of the negative at least. Trying to look here. I don't know, he's looking at the bank. Looking if the balls go if he puts a cue ball up there. Right. Tempting him. He's tempting him to shoot. I doubt he'll shoot. No. He's gonna knock that other ball away. He might even cross this one depending on the angle here. like cross and bump the other two balls. I was gonna put a lot of inside and just not do anything. I might even go for the 12-2. No. Just gonna lay it up. So yeah, both these guys are very careful shooters. They don't give a lot up. Banks rubs towards in his pocket. Wow. What a roll there. Woo-hoo-hoo. That didn't go in, it would have been straight in. What a roll. So it's 4-2. Wayne's wondering what he has to do this game. Oh, man, no. Oh, there's a roll there. A little bigger, maybe not as big as a roll. Right. Yeah. Builds a wall there. Wow. Builds a wall and then protects the ball now. Wow. Go for the bank here. Oh, look at this. How close did he get it? Well, it's up a little ways, but be careful you don't sell out. Yep, just he's going for the make here. Just concentrate on making the ball. Don't think about anything but make the ball. Nope. This is a tight table. That's almost straight in, little angle on this tight table. Nope. Try to spin it and hop up. Yeah. It happens after you don't shoot for a long time. There's no stroke there. Tried to use lots of spin, and that's tough on a tight table to use lots of spin. Going to be tied up here pretty quick.
All right, where are we at?
Oh, wow.
Where are we at, yeah, Big Brian?
These guys, after playing so long, have just fell apart on a couple shots here.
Okay.
So Wayne missed a shot. Yeah. Don't blame. Wayne missed a shot. Not the easiest shot, but then Larry missed a shot. Wayne just missed a shot.
And Larry's taking a quick break. So while that's going on, I just want to let you know, John Bertone from Kamui is going to join me after this game, either because he's on a time constraint. So just real quick, let's talk a little bit more about this M8. You've got the M8, and you're calling it Ultimate Pool League out here. Is that
Ultimate
correct?
Pool League, California, PA.
Yep. So. Check it out on Facebook. You know, they're trying, their goal is to create 64 teams, and based on a 64 team league, they will be able to hold a yearly 10,000 guaranteed first place team added event.
That's correct.
To be held at a larger venue, hopefully, yeah. Right?
Yes, this first year we'll probably use one of the rooms, one of the pool rooms that we have. Whether it be here, whether it be in the valley, at a house of billiards, or plush, just a place that has more tables.
Okay.
As it grows, you know, when we get 100, 200, 300, 400, 500 teams, then the event will be, you know, just get bigger and grow and be held at like a casino.
Okay.
You know, and it'll be right here in Los Angeles, in California.
Right.
Go to Vegas, which isn't too far away. But the thing is, you know, after you spend hotel room,
mm-hmm.
gas, food, even if you win prize money, you know, it's spent.
Yeah, that's true.
This is local. You know, you're going to win the same amount of money here as you would to go to Vegas. And then, like I said, our goal is just to promote pool in the California area here and just, you know, get newer players to play leagues, people that never could even consider playing leagues. The league is great for the better players because they have to always shoot well
mm-hmm.
versus other leagues. And, you know, it's great competition. It's just a blast to come out and have fun. Like I said, back in Minnesota, it's the most popular league out there. And there's a reason it is, you know, after 18 years. You know, people, that's what they like to play. They love the format. They like the prize money, the competition, and how it's ran. So, like I said, the only way you're going to find out is just to come out, give it a try. Guarantee if you play it, you'll be hooked.
Well, that's great. And I'm going to do what I can to help you. You know, hopefully in the future, in the near future, you'll be hearing more about the Ultimate Pool League through me and hopefully through some other portals. I also recommend that you check out other streamers and try to talk and promote through other streamers and other websites. You know, Brian, I wish you the best of luck with it. What I'm going to do is I'm going to invite John Bertone to come in.
Okay.
And I'll be here all weekend, too. So you're welcome to come back and commentate another match. You and Beau Runningen together, you know.
Great.
So, hey, thanks for grinding out this last game with me, man.
What a game it was.
Yeah, I tell you. So thanks again, Brian.
Yep, thank you very much.
Ultimate Pool League, check it out on Facebook. And we're gonna have John Bertone join me in just a second. Hey, you're welcome. Okay, back with you. And welcoming John Bertone from Kamui.
Thank you. Hi, Daniel.
How you doing, John?
I'm doing great.
It's nice to have you visit with me, as always.
It's fun to come out here and visit.
Oh, yeah, it always is. And you know what? For me, it's fun to be doing Rocket for once here from hard times.
Yeah, it is a change, huh?
Mm-hmm.
This match is taking a little while, isn't it?
Yeah, I mean, they've got this thing called the Martin Rule, which is supposed to speed the game up. But these guys are such good players that they really know how to grind it out, you know, no matter what rule you throw on them. So, you know, they're... They're changing the way this rule is supposed to be structured. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Well,
it's nice to see two really good players go at it. But in some cases, it's not, because it's almost like watching paint dry sometimes.
Yeah, huh? Yeah, I know. Yeah, you have to be really a one-pocket connoisseur, really, to hang in there with us. But I want to... you know, once again, thank you for joining me here. And John's been really busy lately, haven't you?
Yeah.
Every time I talk to you, you're slammed.
Yeah, I am totally slammed. It's the whole month of July is what's really really on our plate right now, and it's the BCA trade show where, you know, I'm running to be a board member of the BCA, so there's an election going on there, so, you know, I'm making phone calls and campaigning as much as I can, as well as, you know, answering customers that give us, you know, phone calls and stuff. And then planning for Kamui Japan coming over, and they're going to be here on the 8th. And, you know, I have that. That's that right there took a whole week's worth of planning to make sure that, you know, I have them entertained each day all the way up to when we go to Chicago, which is on the 16th. And then
yeah, you have a whole itinerary.
Yeah, and
that's Masato, right?
Yeah, and Masato is going to be running a marathon in Chicago.
Is he really?
Yeah, after the BCA
show.
How
old is Masato?
He's a couple years younger than me.
Okay, all right. So he's still a whippersnapper.
Yeah,
right.
Yeah. And that's kind of impressive. But of course, I'm going to get my butt down to Tunica and be part of the Kamui Pay or Play event, which by that time it's going to be, you know, going full force, and I'm going to be missing the first couple days of that because I'm going to be in Chicago. But I have that all planned out where I have a couple of my friends that are really good Kamui people. Danny Cintron and
Larry hit his head on the light, you know. Maybe now he'll stop jumping up so much. He's been missing a lot of shots today, and he's been jumping up on his stroke. He just looked over and said, "I'm still alive."
Does he really work for Disneyland?
Yes, he does work for Disneyland. I don't know what he does, but maybe somebody in the chat.
He's wearing a work shirt.
Maybe
really
that could
cool.
be a trivia question for us to give away a piece of chalk.
Yeah.
Doesn't Kamui have a booth in Disneyland somewhere?
Yeah, really. So yeah, I'm gonna be.
So pay or play.
Yes.
And that's exciting. I have a commercial that, because Inside Pool is going to be streaming the whole thing, right?
Yes,
8 days long.
The whole thing. And, you know, JR has been absolutely great at helping us promote it and getting the word out there. So, so JR, if you're listening, hey, you know, thanks a lot for all the help. I mean, it's priceless, the amount of exposure he's been able to help me get. And, you know, to do the live stream, you know, that's a lot of work. So 8 days worth of it, that's really awesome.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, I think the longest event that I did was the West Coast Challenge event up at Chris Swartz Pool Hall, the California Billiard Club. You know, and that was exhausting.
In Mountain View, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. How many days was that? It was, what, 4 days?
5 days.
5 days, yeah. Yeah.
But you guys, we were doing one pocket and 10 ball. You guys are doing 9 ball, bank pool, one pocket, 8 ball, and straight pool.
And straight pool, yeah.
5 games. Yes. And it's going to be a tournament that is covered by 16 tables, is that correct? Or
no, we're
8 tables.
4 tables.
4 tables.
4 10-foot tables.
Wow.
Yes.
Wow. Have you been taking pre-registration?
Yeah. If you wanted to pre-register, you can go to payorplaypool.com and should be able to pre-register there. But, you know, we have enough openings for everybody. So, you know, everybody show up. We can get you in.
Yeah, that's right. I remember I played the pay or play 10 ball event in Reno.
Yeah. Yeah, you did, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Yes. So it was a little bit of excitement there in how it works out and how it starts up and works out and how you get through the field, doesn't it?
Yeah, and it
you
is.
You have first-hand experience at that. I forgot about that. You were there?
Yeah.
Yeah. I was there with Edward, and Edward assistant is the brains behind the pay or play system, the tournament system.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, it's an awesome way to challenge yourself and your opponent, as well as, you know, your ability to try to match yourself up against other opponents in the chart.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, it's a whole different spectrum now.
What are they starting it out at $2 or $10?
I think we're starting it off at $2.50 to get in.
$2.50 to get in.
Yeah.
Yeah. And if you wanna advance through the levels of that, you have to just keep winning. If you want to just skip all of that and go straight to the
final 32? I think it's either the final 64 or final 32. We won't know till we actually, you know, start
so
our tournament.
You won't really even know what the final buy-in is?
I think we have it there on Pay or Play Pool.
Okay.
But it's so easy to adjust and change that I keep that open.
Hmm. And each event's going to be 1,000 added, or 1,000 guaranteed for first place.
Yes, 1,000 guaranteed for first place.
How deep will you pay? Will you pay
top
beyond
three
that?
Levels?
Okay.
Top three levels, and depending on how many players come in and how it all pans itself out, you know, we may pay deeper. But it's all experiment right now.
Yeah.
We got to see how everybody understands how to play themselves through the chart and play each other, and then we'll determine that.
Okay.
Then we'll get it to go. Final 16.
Final 16. Yeah. I guess Eddie's watching.
Yeah, Eddie's listening. Hey, Eddie, how you doing?
Eddie assistant actually came.
He just
and joined
me.
He joined me at the Sticks Billiards
yes,
tournament that
did.
I did recently, the one pocket Joe Martin event.
Yes.
And
so yeah, it's all the way up to the final 16.
Look at this! Someone makes a ball.
So what's really cool is, you know, a pro player that wants to pay up to the final 16.
Yeah, yeah.
He can.
Yeah, yeah. Now, a lot of people think that, I'm sure a lot of people automatically assume that, like, you know, you're able to just do this by yourself with Eddie, but, you know, it took a lot of people to kind of collectively... put this event on.
Yeah.
Why don't you share with us some of those people and some of those partners that you've gained?
Yeah, it first started off with you know, Diamond telling us, you know, they're going to have the 10-foot tables down there, and we're thinking, well, you know, that's awesome. You know, 10-foot tables, that's great, and it's a great way to introduce the pay or play pool into the, you know, that arena.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you got the 10-foot tables, and you have the pay or play going on, and people are going to be watching this and learning something new. So it was just a great win-win from that scenario. And then, you know, the sponsors are absolutely great. You know, we have Simonis that came in, you know, right away. You know, Ivan Lee is an awesome guy. You know, I really enjoy our phone conversations and how we can try to make, you know, a positive difference in the industry. And we got Seabirds, and we also got Viking. Mm-hmm. And what's really cool about Viking is they're introducing something new to the industry. Yeah.
What's that?
It's called the Exact Shaft.
Very interesting.
It's the exact exact shot.
Wow.
Yeah. So, you know, it's a...
Well, Wayne takes it. Wayne takes it.
Oh, we're over? It's over.
Yeah, but you and I are still here.
Yeah. So,
what a grindhouse match, folks.
Yeah.
Wayne takes it 2-1. It was a hill match.
Who's up next on this table?
We are going to have another match soon here. Sexy Ricky versus I don't know who. So, who are you playing, Ricky? Oh, he's just coming over to the stream table. He wants to play on the stream table. Okay, so we're done here, and we're going to have another match real soon. Stick around. John Bertone is with me from Kamui, and I'm actually going to give away a piece of chalk today on the stream. Compliments of John Bertone and Kamui Tips. And it's the new Kamui 121
Alpha version.
Yes. Which is, you can put that in the freezer all day if you want.
Right? Yeah, I know. It's so funny. Yeah.
So stand by, guys. We're going to have another match real soon.